Hello everyone, so welcome to this course entitled Initiation to Proxy Detection for the Monitoring of Plant Growth in a Control Environment. My name is David Rousseau at University of Angers. And here's what we are going to talk about. We're going to talk about the phenotyping of plants in control environment. So the phenotype results from the interaction of genotype and environment. And it's often the case in plant biology that people want to work in control environment so that somehow they have an input on this relation between genotype and environment. Although it's not the full real life outside world, it opened the door to scientific questions which can really be addressed in this control environment. This is also the case for plant pathology studies that you have to be in control environment because you are observing the interaction between plant and diseases and you want to avoid the dissemination of these diseases in the outside world. So here is a kind of global view of the different approaches that you can select if you want to do phenotyping in control environment. A first approach on the left here corresponds to the use of sensors that you will bring individually to each plant. The second one corresponds to the fact that you will convey the plant and bringing under a unique sensor. And the last approach corresponds to have a grid of sensors, so a cohort of sensors. So let's go through all the pros and cons of each of these strategies and explain the one that we selected in this course. So the first approach corresponding to bringing the sensor to the plant, the pros are the possibility, since you bring the sensors close to the plant, to be very high resolution, to be as close as possible to the plant, to have a spatial selectivity which can be as small as you want. Also, you can shine a light, the one that you choose, to do the imaging. There are some, however, pitfalls, just like the fact that the measurement will not be synchronized on the life of the plant. If you have thousands of plants and that your measurement takes you minutes, it will take you very long time to do this. And all the measurement will not be taken at the same biological stage of each plant. For instance, plants have circadian cycles, which correspond to different physiological states at a different time of the day. Also, since you bring the robots with the robots close to the plant, you might cause a shadow onto the plant, which might be different a different part of the experiment. And again, as I already stated, this is rather slow. The second approach, so here on the second part of the slide, you would like to bring the plant to the sensor. That's especially relevant when you have a very expensive sensor, and because you bring the plant to a special cabinet, you have a high flexibility on how you want to do the measure. Again, you can choose a specific light to have specific contrast and so on. Again, some pitfalls, limits are the fact that, again, the measurement is not synchronized. It's possibly invasive because it's well known now that conveying the plant actually is not without causing any stress to the plant. So the life of the plant will not be the same if they stay at the same place or if they are conveyed. Mechanical constraint on this is not non-zero invasive. So the last approach is the one that we will develop during this this course, is to use a grid of sensors, meaning replication of the same sensors, enabling a synchronized acquisition, enabling then a fast acquisition, enabling something which would be non-invasive because the sensors would be deployed inside the control environment, and it's directly integrated in the growth chamber or in the greenhouse. The limits, possible limits, is the fact that this approach can be expensive, except if you use low-cost sensors. And this is why this course is focused on the low-cost sensors used for plant phenotyping.